Go.
Hello, dear fellows. Today we are at Cultural Events, which is the sign of the book Heráclito Cepeda. We are located at the Centro Cultural Jaime Sabines. This event is such an important one because it represents one of the most important Mexican characters, which is one of the most Chapanecan authors in history.
The event began with the speaker introducing the members of the Presidium, which was composed of Deputy Zoe Robledo, author of the book Elba Macias, and book writer Roberto Rico. Then Deputy Zoe took the word and started to read out loud some of the passages contained in the book, trying to explain what Cepeda went through and meant, also including his own opinion.
El mundo, ese lugar que nos otorga, nos sirve también para aislarnos, para hacerse fuerte dentro de unas fronteras, para cerrar nuestra visión a un nacionalismo que muchas veces termina siendo vacío.
The second person to take the word was Roberto Pico, who also delighted the audience with his personal description of how marvelous of a man Heráclito Cepeda was, and how outstanding of a writer he once was as well.
En el despliegue ilimitado de sus aptitudes creadoras, resulta ejemplar, aunque inimitable, su enorme capacidad comunicativa.
The last person to talk was Elba Macias, author of the book and wife of the deceased Heráclito Cepeda, who narrated what her experience meeting his husband was like and how she fell in love with him.
Pues yo. ¿Y por qué? Porque así estaba de guapo cuando me enamoré de él. Por eso lo elegí. Y ya después estaría toda su trayectoria de vida hasta...
Once the event was over, we took the time to make some interviews.
Un compendio fotográfico de la selección de los momentos más significativos a lo largo de la vida de este gran personaje, que fue Heráclito Cepeda.
Good day. Today we are at the Festival of Ciencias y Humanidades located at the Tecnológico Monterrey Campus Chiapas. The coverage of this event is so important because it is not only from an academic posture, but also from a cultural one, as the students were not only encouraged to do so for the sake of their studies, but also to show their love for the nation and how special it can be, which can be seen in the effort they put to make the various altars and costumes.
The students first arrived at 12 p.m., bringing the materials they have been working on since the beginning of the semester, in order to set up everything from the altars to the singing stage and dancing and photography halls.
What's the trick? I wish I knew. I'm so done with thinking through all the things I could have been, and I know you wanted to. All it takes is that one look you do, and I run right back to you. You cross the line, and it's time to say F you. What's the point in saying that when you know how I'll react? You think you can just take it back, but shit just don't work like that. You're the drug that I'm addicted to, and I want you so bad. Guess I'm stuck with you, and that's that.
Then at 5 p.m., the event began and people started to arrive. The organizers divided people by groups and sent them into the already established route, which would first cover the drama and dancing hall, then the photography and painting hall, then the reading hall, and lastly, they will go out to enjoy some festive bread and listen to the singing club. When the event was over, we took the time to make some interviews.
Me gustó mucho porque habla de todas las tradiciones mexicanas y te explicaban una leyenda que era como más mexicana que de Halloween y todo eso estaba más enfocado al Día de Muertos.